You hear about the same smart home brands all the time. You know, the ones that every YouTuber and influencer keeps talking about? They have the marketing, the hype, and the name recognition. But today I want to show you a brand that you probably haven't heard of. And honestly, it's one of the most reliable systems that I use. It's called YoLink. They're a smaller company with a surprisingly solid lineup of smart home devices that use one secret weapon that's indispensable for larger properties and outdoor setups. It's a long-range protocol called LoRa.
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 LoRa. Please be quiet.
LoRa, which can reach up to a quarter mile. So if you've ever had a sensor go offline in your garage or your crawl space, or needed smarts to reach the farthest parts of your backyard, then this video is for you. So stick around and let's jump into it. Hey, I'm Robert, and Oconee Smart Homes exists to make real homes more convenient, accessible, and safe with smart home technology. We serve real customers right here in Oconee County, Georgia, but this channel is for anyone who wants to make a simpler, smarter home. And before we get started, no, this video isn't sponsored, and I've never received any money from YoLink. They don't even know I'm making this video. I just happen to like their tech and think that it's a hidden gem that you deserve to know about. So what is LoRa and how does it work? LoRa simply stands for long range. It's a low-powered radio technology that allows devices to communicate over really long distances, way further than Wi-Fi, Zigbee, or even standard Z-Wave. Instead of relying on your home network, LoRa devices communicate sending tiny bits of data over low-frequency radio waves that can travel up to hundreds of feet through walls, past trees, and across your yard. Think of it like a walkie-talkie system for your smart devices that can whisper across your entire property while using almost no battery. That's why YoLink devices can reach places that most smart home devices can't. You might be thinking, do I really need another protocol and yet another hub? I get it, but stick with me because the use cases here are pretty common. Just take my home as the example. We live on about a 1-acre lot with a 2-story house on a crawl space. So today I'm gonna share my top 5 reasons that I use YoLink plus 2 bonuses, and then I'll answer your most anticipated questions. Number 1 are temperature sensors in the attic. I like to keep an eye on the climate of my home from top to bottom, and knowing how hot it is in the attic might keep me from coming up here or enable me to automate ventilation. And the same thing when it's cold. If it's too cold, we risk pipes freezing. We might want to turn on the lights for warmth or open up the hatch to allow the heat in the house to come up. Either way, it's a good idea to know the temperature up in the attic so that we can manage it, and YoLink is the perfect solution. Number 2 are sensors in my freezers. See, like a lot of families, we have a deep freezer out in the garage, and a few years ago, it died and we lost hundreds of dollars worth of food. Never again. See, the YoLink temperature sensors can reach through the house and into the thick metal walls of the freezer and give us an accurate temperature reading even at well below freezing temperatures. Other sensors just went offline or didn't work or had batteries that died too quickly. Now I can be alerted if there's a problem and jump in to save our food. Number 3 is any device that I need to connect inside my detached garage, or maybe your workshop or a shed. See, my detached garage functions as a workshop and my office. And even with the YoLink hub inside the house, the devices connect flawlessly out here with no extra hub or range extender needed. I've even used it for a customer's pool house where other protocols just couldn't reach. Number 4 are water shutoff systems. A whole home water shutoff can be a lifesaver, but not if the valve goes offline. And see, most of the time, water shutoff valves are located in the extremities of the home, maybe the basement, the crawl space, or the garage. Mine's in my crawl space. Using YoLink allows me to install the valve where it's needed and spread the leak sensors around the home, knowing that the connection will hold steady. And as an added bonus, the direct-to-device connectivity means that the water shutoff automation can be triggered directly from the leak sensor to the valve. Number 5 is an outdoor sensor at my back gate. I recently built a gate into our fence. Our property backs up to a pretty busy street, and I need to know when that gate is left open. YoLink's outdoor contact sensor works flawlessly and is weather ready right out of the box. And now for the bonuses. Number 6, multifamily dwellings and managed properties. Because of the range, YoLink devices are great for landlords or property managers. You can deploy the devices across multiple units and manage them centrally in one app. It's great for commercial use cases too, and YoLink even has a special platform for this called Radius. Number 7, novel automations. When I use this phrase with customers, I mean, if there's something that you want to automate, we're going to try to find a way. And YoLink has so many unique devices that open up creative possibilities. Need to monitor your pool levels or maybe your soil moisture? Check. They've got switches, sensors, locks, alarms, irrigation, and even key fobs, all with long-range reliability. So for you and your novel automations, only your imagination is stopping you. Before I jump into your questions, do me a favor and hit the like button. It helps more people discover hidden gems like this. Now let me try to answer what I think will be your most common questions. Is it any good? I've used YoLink for about 3 years now with zero issues. Battery life lasts years, not months, and reliability, it's their biggest strength. They built core features to ensure that your devices work when needed. Even if you have a power outage or loss of internet, your devices can still work locally. Loss of power? Most devices offer a battery backup. Internet outage? Key automations can function over a peer-to-peer direct-to-device connection. What ecosystems does it support? Does it support Matter? Your YoLink devices are going to communicate through their LoRa hubs. To get Matter support, you have to use their local hub, which feels pricey at about $200. But their standard hub is super cheap, about 20 bucks, or included free in a lot of the device bundles. They also offer hubs that have different features like a built-in speaker for custom announcements, battery backup, and even cellular backup. So standard, you'll get support for Alexa and Google Home. You'll get Matter support with the local hub. And for the DIY crowd, it does support Homebridge and Home Assistant. Can I use it without the cloud? Mostly yes. The devices themselves don't require a connection to the cloud to operate, but you will need the cloud to use their app unless you have the local hub, which enables full local control and Matter operation. One big benefit of the app though is that it comes with email and SMS notifications. So you can be alerted when key automations trigger or based on device states where you might need a critical alert. Is it secure? The YoLink app is secured with login information and biometric options. And YoLink hosts their servers on Amazon Web Services in the US, which is good to know for data privacy. Who is this brand anyway? YoLink is a brand of YoSmart, which is a US-based company out of California. And best I can tell, they have fewer than 50 employees. Any gotchas? If I had to nitpick, it's the design. These devices aren't exactly eye candy, but most of the use cases are for places where they won't be seen, in crawl spaces or sheds or behind appliances. And that's the way that smart home tech should be, invisible and intuitive. YoLink isn't trying to be the flashiest smart home brand, they're trying to be the most reliable. So for sensors outdoors or leak detection or any place that you need long distances to work, well, except your relationships, it's one of the most underrated smart home brands out there. And if I had to tack on another one, it's the reliance on the cloud. Yes, they offer local control, but they put it in a higher price range, which makes it feel a little less accessible. So what do you think? Would you use YoLink in your home? Drop a comment below and let us know your use case. God bless you. We'll see you next time.
We mustn't forget Laura. Please be quiet.